Hi there, my name is Kendrick and welcome to Travel and Live Free. In this video, I'm gonna do a review of the RBC WestJet World Elite MasterCard, and that video is gonna come up right now. As of making this video, the RBC WestJet World Elite MasterCard has a promotion that ends on May 31st of 2021. And in that promotion, instead of giving you 250 WestJet dollars, they're gonna give you an additional 350 WestJet dollars. So basically, you're gonna get 250 WestJet dollars after being approved for the card, and another 100 WestJet dollars after your first purchase with the card. You also get 1.5% WestJet dollars back for every dollar that you spend on everyday purchases, and 2% WestJet dollars back on flights or packages when you make a purchase through WestJet. If you activate the card and use it before June 30th of 2021, you can also get a round trip companion fare voucher where the taxes and fees are completely waived. So basically, it's a buy one, get one free. It seems to me that they're offering this promotion though during the pandemic, when they know that a lot of people are probably not gonna be redeeming that. So I think it's a little bit tricky on their part, but at the same time, if you do wanna use that companion fare voucher for flights with WestJet, it might not be a bad idea to use it. Hopefully the pandemic does end sometime at the later part of 2021, and you can go ahead and use that voucher by then. One of the biggest perks for the WestJet World Elite MasterCard is that your first check bags is for free, which saves you some money. You also get a no-fee Boingo Wi-Fi internet in flight or on the go. And the card also comes with a whole host of insurance benefits. Insurance benefits includes a 15-day travel medical insurance for anyone that's under 65 years old, trip interruption insurance, auto rental loss or damage insurance, hotel or motel burglary insurance, travel accident insurance, emergency purchase and flight delay insurance, purchase security and extended warranty insurance. And you might be thinking, what can you do with that 350 WestJet dollars? Well, unfortunately, they did nerf the program and it's not as good as what it was before, because before you can redeem those WestJet dollars at a fixed price, and that was a fantastic deal when flying between Canadian cities. However, right now it's not very good because of the recent changes. Definitely Aeroplan will beat WestJet in terms of the frequent flyer program, and the 350 WestJet dollar is pretty much equivalent to about $350. Now the card does have an annual fee of $119, so basically if you take $350 minus $119, then that's how much money you are coming ahead with that 350 WestJet dollars. So basically you're gonna earn about $231 that can go towards a flight booking, which you might think, okay, that's not very good really. And yeah, you are right, it's not very good, especially for the time and effort that you use to collect points on this card. Other frequent flyer programs might be better. However, there is a possibility that in the future they might improve the program, because a lot of people will complain or they will lose customers. So it's not a bad idea to keep collecting the WestJet dollars, especially because it's very easy to earn them. You just have to have your first purchase and then you get the points. A lot of people use the product switch method in order to get around the crappy WestJet dollar program right now and get another card that is a lot better, such as the Avion, for example. So that's another strategy that you can follow if you don't like collecting WestJet dollars, because they're not worth as much as they used to. Anyways, that's about it for this video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave your comments below. And don't forget to sign up to the Travel and Live Free newsletter, where you can get a 10-step cheat sheet on how to travel around the world. You'll also get the latest tips and strategies on how to save money on travel for Canadians, how to go on around the world adventure travel for Canadians, and how to use travel to get more freedom in your life as a Canadian. You can sign up for that newsletter in the description below. Until next time, I'll see you then.